Greetings from Columbia College. We're in the Cougar Dome, where today the Columbia Cougars entertain the Webster Gorlocks in basketball competition. The Cougars come in with a record of 9-4, 2-1 in the American Midwest Conference. Webster University, located on the south side of St. Louis, comes in with a record of 2-8. They have yet to play a St. Louis Intercollegiate Athletic Conference game, so they have not cracked the seal yet on this year's conference record or conference schedule. But they come in on a two-game winning streak as they posted a victory on Thursday against Williams Baptist, coming from behind to win 82-73. And prior to that, they got win number one on the year, so they are off and running. But they come in a little nicked up, as Carl Moore will not be available today due to an injury he sustained during practice this week. But for Webster, they're coached by Chris Bunch, and we'll hear from him in just a moment. After that, we'll check in with Thomas Brock, the head coach of the Cougars. This is Columbia Cougar Basketball.
Right now, get $50 off a Hy-Vee Plus premium membership with code Mahomes.
Back here at the Cougar Dome, Webster University here today for action with the Cougars. And Chris Bunch is the head coach. 21 years, coach. Time's gone by for you quickly in St. Louis.
Yes, it has. It's, you told me when I came from East Tennessee 21 years ago, I'd still be here that much time later. I don't know if I would have believed you or not.
Your ball club's caught a little fire here as you come in on a two-game winning streak.
Yeah, we played some tough teams early and had to kind of find the right combinations early, and so that, and then we've had a different guy or two hurt, seem like, every game, and we've got one hurt today too. So the mixture of all that sometimes is kind of meant for different lineups and different rotations and people playing different roles, and you're doing all that and trying to find your way while you're playing some really good people. Sometimes that's tough. They'll show you your warts a little bit, but we've done a good job for the last couple of games of kind of figuring out, you know, the right combinations and whatnot. So hopefully we can continue to play well today.
How about the challenges today taking on Columbia?
They're big. I mean, they're not just big, but they're good, but they're big. I mean, it's much like when we played Washington University. You know, it's they present a size problem for us, and especially with Carl Moore out today, it's going to really be a problem. They're going to be a lot bigger than us, and so, you know, that's definitely something we're going to have to try and overcome.
Coach Bunch, appreciate your time. Thanks.
All right, thank you.
We'll be back with more Cougar basketball in a moment.
Time for car maintenance? No need to interrupt your day. Have Lee's Tire Mobile Express come to you. Now delivering hassle-free service in a state-of-the-art van equipped for on-the-spot oil changes, tire repairs, tire installation, tire rotations, and balancing. Enjoy the convenience of having the same quality workmanship as the last 50 years brought to your door. Call or visit us online to book an appointment with Lee's Tire Mobile Express. Now serving your location.
This afternoon here at Columbia College, the Cougars entertain Webster University, and Coach Thomas Brock, interesting matchup here today with the Gorlocks.
Yeah, interesting matchup, NCAA Division III team. You know, Coach Bunch has been there for a while and done a good job with over the years. Got a chance to play him last year and excited about the competition today.
A ball club that comes in here, they've been struggling, but they've won two in a row.
Yeah, they had a slow start, but have won two in a row and, you know, beat Williams Baptist, and who's in our league, on Thursday. They look like they've been playing better on film, and they've got some guards that can do some things, so we'll have our hands full.
How about your ball club, Coach? You had a nice win against College of the Ozarks and really took them right out of the game with your defense.
Yeah, I held them to 19 in the first half, and so I was pleased with our defensive effort against C of O. And, you know, and we've talked to our guys about this, and they know it. You know, when we're at our best and we're rolling, it's because we're defending at a high level and we're stringing together stops and rebounding on the defensive end. And then sometimes that can lead to easier offense because the defense is in transition and, you know, you can flow right into whatever you want to do. And so it always starts on the defensive end for us.
How about your injury situation? We know Bo Washer's going to be gone probably the remainder of the year, but how about Cole Gerken?
Well, Cole was limited in practice this week. He did practice with us some. He is going to dress out tonight. You know, I don't know how much we'll see him tonight, but he's working his way back in. You know, we'd like to get him healthy and give us a little more depth at that wing spot, but we'll see if he's able to go tonight.
We're in an interesting juncture of the schedule. You've got this game and then a couple more before semester break. I would think focus is something you'll have to emphasize.
Yeah, it is an interesting time because next week we start finals, and then we've got our last game of the semester, you know, next Saturday. So this has been a good week for us. I thought Tuesday's competition was good, and we'll have a good test today. Gives us a chance to stay in rhythm and in flow for what will be an important conference game next week.
What area you want to see your ball club really concentrate on today?
Well, I mentioned defense. The other piece of that is rebounding. You know, Webster's aggressive to the offensive glass. They had 19 rebounds in their last game, and they're quick. So we need to finish possessions with a defensive rebound. We do have a size advantage inside that I'd like to exploit. So hopefully we can get the ball to the paint with the post entry and with the dribble drive and see if we can win the rim area.
Coach Brock, we'll see you after the game. Thanks.
All right, thank you.
Back with more in a moment. This is Cougar Basketball.
Wondering, what is Socket Fiber? Socket Fiber is the fastest, most reliable internet service available in mid-Missouri. So, how do I get Socket Fiber at my house? First, check to see if you currently have Socket Fiber to your home by going to socket.net/fiberhood and checking your address. If Socket does not have fiber currently available to your home, just go to socket.net/fiberhood to request it to your home. Request Socket Fiber today and become the next Fiberhood.
Your voice lets him know he's safe. Shelter Insurance does the same for you. Roadside assistance provided by Road America is now included with your auto policy. We'll take care of you. While you take care of what's most important. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
Downtown Appliance is celebrating 60 years. Our secret? Happy customers.
I had experiences with a number of people at Downtown Appliance, all of which were beyond my expectations in terms of kindness, understanding, being good listeners. They are incredibly friendly, and they heard me in terms of what I wanted and what my expectations were and are, and they've met and exceeded those.
Celebrate 60 years with Downtown Appliance Home Center, East Broadway.
To everyone who loves great food, let us make you a meal the Wisconsin way.
We cook each Butterburger to order for you and the people you love, so it's the best part of your day.
The best.
The best.
And every creamy scoop of fresh frozen custard, pure happiness.
Pure happiness.
Pure happiness. Because where Culver's comes from.
And the heart of America's Dairyland.
Our love.
Our love for fresh food is as strong as our love for all of you.
From Wisconsin with love.
Welcome to Delicious.
Don't have time for car maintenance? No need to interrupt your day. Have Lee's Tire Mobile Express come to you. Now delivering hassle-free service in a state-of-the-art van equipped for on-the-spot oil changes, tire repairs, tire installation, tire rotations, and balancing. Enjoy the convenience of having the same quality workmanship as the last 50 years brought to your door. Call or visit us online to book an appointment with Lee's Tire Mobile Express. Now serving your location.
Pop was here last week. He was talking about Brooklyn and the place Brooklyn was at, how they were really, like, thriving right now. But he was, you know, he was trying to pull people up with him. And he wasn't even to where he was about to be. He just was trying to, he was well on his way. It's just tragic. 20 years old, rest in peace, God bless Pop Smoke.
Look, mama made it. Mama made it, we made it. Mama made it. Thank God that I made it. Mama made it, we made it. Look, mama made it. Look, I remember the days. Same fit 4 weeks straight. I used to eat 50 cent cake. Now it's for leaves. It's for leaves for the steak.
Today's meeting between the Columbia Cougars and Gorlocks of Webster University is the fourth ever. Cougars have never fallen to Webster. Webster, of course, NCAA Division III program out of St. Louis. And again, they come in with a mark of 2-8, but they've won their last two games. But unfortunately, they've got to take on this Webster or Columbia club without their top scorer in Kent Moore Jr. As Cougars also nicked up a little bit. Not sure how much we'll see Cole Gerken. And, of course, Bo Washer has been lost for the year. The Shelter Insurance starting lineups are right around the corner. We now pause for the playing of the national anthem here on the campus of Columbia College.
And at this time, we please rise, remove your hats, and face the flag as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Crowd still gathering here at the Cougar Dome as Columbia looking to wrap up their home schedule here in 2022. They've got a trip to St. Louis to take on Missouri Baptist on Saturday, a week from today in St. Louis, and that'll be it. And then second semester at that trip to St. Louis, a big game in conference action. Now the Shelter Insurance starting lineups will begin with the Gorlocks of Webster University. Starting at a forward position from Kingston, Jamaica, is Javon Nugent. Nugent starts at the forward spot, 6 foot, 298 pounder. He is a senior. Starting at a guard position will be Jason Coleman. Coleman's a junior at 6 foot. He is out of Memphis, Tennessee. Starting at another forward position will be Jamar Sykes the second. Sykes is a freshman at 6 foot two. He is from Gateway High School in St. Louis. Wynn Brown Jr. will start at the other guard spot. He's a 5'7", 150 pounder out of Memphis, Tennessee. And again, he is a senior. And rounding out the starting lineup is Marcus Becken. Becken is 6'5", 190 pounds. He'll play the post. He's out of Chicago, Illinois. And he attended Westchester St. Louis, Westchester St. Joseph High School. That's the Shelter Insurance starting lineups for the visitors. Now for the Columbia Cougars, starting at one of the guard spots is Trendon Tisdale. Tisdale, 6'3", a sophomore, averaging 10 points a game out of Tulsa, Oklahoma. Starting at the other guard position is Tony Burks, the Cougar leading scorer, averaging 20 points a game. 6'2", a senior from St. Louis, went to St. Mary High School and a transfer from Wabash Valley Community College. Marlon Allen will start at a forward spot, 6'5", a junior. Allen is from Orlando, Florida. He went to Boone High School and a transfer from Hillsborough Community College. Colin Parker, the number two scorer on this Cougar roster, will start at a forward spot. 6'7", a sophomore from Montgomery City, Missouri, 18 points and 6 rebounds a game. And rounding out the starting lineup is Carson Parker, Collins' older brother, 6'8", a sophomore from Montgomery City, Missouri, averaging 6 points, 4 rebounds per game. The officials for this afternoon's game are Kenny Seifert, Evan Goosen, and Patrick Remus. Today's officials are brought to you by Lee's Tire Company. You may not like every call this afternoon, but you'll love your one call to Lee's Tire Company. Lee's Tire Company, the official car care specialist of Cougar Athletics. Columbia controls the opening tip as Tisdale brings it in the front court. Webster drops into a man-to-man defense. Down low it goes to Colin Parker. Collin tied up, kicks it out to Tisdale. He launches a three from the left wing, no good. And the rebound cleared out of there by Nugent. And Webster will bring it up the floor. Webster decked out in their Navy uniforms, trimmed in gold. With it on the left sideline is Coleman. Coleman out top to Nugent. Now back to the left wing to Sykes. Circling around Sykes, getting pressure from Tisdale. To the right wing to Beckton. Now back out top, Nugent's three-point shot, no good. Rebound Burks. Here comes Columbia as Tony brings it up the floor. Burks works to the right, has it on the wing, kicks it out to Colin Parker for a three. It's in and out, no good. And the rebound scrambled for. Then picking it up off the deck is Jamard Sykes the second. He pushes it up the floor. Sykes has it for a three. That won't go. Battle for the board. And the rebound controlled by the Garlocks. Out top it comes, and this long three-point shot from Wayne Brown is good. And it's 3-0 Garlocks as we're a minute and a half in. Tisdale across the stripe, right side Burks, back to Tisdale, down low Colin Parker. Colin on the baseline, little push shot off the window is good. And that is automatic when he fires that shot. 3-2 Columbia, trailing by one. On the right side, Brown, out top, top to Key, Beckton. Down low, Beckton drives, knocks down the shot off the right block, and he's fouled by Parker. Colin, or rather Carson Parker. Carson Parker called for the first foul in the game. Give the bucket to Beckton. He'll try to complete the three-point play. Beckton's free throw is no good. It's a 5-2 three-point lead for Webster. Last year, the Cougars beat Webster here in Columbia, 91-72. Kind of one-sided. Colin Parker back it in, tied up, tried to feed it across the paint, threw it away, so it was intercepted by Jason Coleman. Down the far sideline, Brown. Brown kicks it out top on the move. Is Nugent. Nugent kicks it back to the top to Brown. Penetrating, they feed it down low. Jumper off the baseline's good from Marcus Beckton. He's got 4 points, and it's a 5-point lead for Webster here in the opening moments. Tisdale pulls up, left side of the free throw line, kicks it out to Carson Parker, down to Colin through the hands of Burks. Colin Parker feeds to Carson underneath. Carson tied up under the bucket. Tisdale from the left wing, good. Trendon Tisdale now averaging 10 points a game, and he's shooting 38% from the three-point arc. Beckton has it out on the wing. Beckton kicks it off, gets the ball to Sykes. Back to Beckton. Beckton with it to free throw line. Backdoor pass broken up by Burks, but then kept alive by the Garlocks. And it'll be Columbia basketball as they get the turnover. Just getting things started. Left side, Colin Parker, Carson Parker. Now to the right side, to Marlon Allen. Down to Colin Parker. He took a slash and was able to control the ball, but couldn't control the shot. Brown into the front court. He works left side to Beckton, into the left corner to Coleman. Coleman working on a baseline, shut down there, kicks it out to Nugent. That shot short. Tisdale with a weak side board. Here comes Columbia. Colin Parker works to the left side into the corner to Allen. Down low, Carson Parker with a power move to a bucket. Carson Parker ties the game at 7. Jason Coleman marches it up the floor. He gets to the top of the key to Nugent. Right side Brown driving baseline, draws the attention to Carson Parker out to Beckton, and Beckton knocks down the 18-footer. He's got 6. 9-7. Warlocks with the early lead. On the dribble. Tisdale down low to Colin Parker. Colin trying to go deep. Can't get a shot off. Fires it out to Allen. And Marlon Allen drains the 3. He's only shooting 11% out there, but he knocked that one down. And the Cougars have the lead. They're up 10-9. Beckton has it on the elbow. Now out top. With it there, Nugent. Nugent drives baseline, tied up, puts up a shot and scores. Javon Nugent with a bucket. He's out of Piper High School in Kingston, Jamaica. Tisdale, down low Carson Parker, working against Beckton. Now out to Tisdale, Colin Parker. Allen with it on the baseline. Allen drives, runner on the way, no good. Rebound Nugent. And back come the Gorlocks. With it on the right side, Sykes. Beckton, guarded by Carson Parker. Now to the left side, to Sykes. Pass was intended down low for Wynn Brown Jr. And the ball was tipped out of bounds. It'll be Columbia ball. Nate Jones checks in for the Gorlocks, and Nugent will get a breather. Also for the Gorlocks, Josh Luster checks in. For the Cougars, Tommy Hafer checks in for Columbia. Also checking in is Brock Davis. As Tisdale works it to the right side. Tisdale to Colin Parker. Davis, left side, Burks. Burks hasn't had many touches. 3-point shot good from Tony Burks. Tony Burks shooting 27% from beyond the arc. And Columbia now has pushed their lead to 4. With it on the left side, Beckton. Beckton works back to the right. Kicks it off into the corner. Gets the ball to Sykes. Sykes to Brown out of the corner to answer. That 3 no good. Davis with a rebound to Burks. Burks strong to the rack. Missed the shot. Didn't get the call. And here come the Gorlocks back the other way. Sykes has it. Kicks it in the corner. And out of bounds in that left corner is Josh Luster from Mineral Area Community College. Check it in now for the Cougars is Dukan Kara, otherwise known as Dodo Kara, out of Istanbul, Turkey. Kara with it on the point, pulls up, kicks it out to Davis, now to Burks. Burks, a member of the 1,000 Point Club here at Columbia College, feeds it down low inside, and Brock Davis lays it in. 15-11, inbounds pass stolen by Cora. That shot is blocked by Luster. Cora made the steal and drew the foul. And the foul will be charged to Luster. First foul of the game on Webster. 12:56 to play, first half. Cora to the free throw line where he's shooting just 56%, and he left that one short. Dukan Kara, 5'10 junior, transfer from South Puget Sound. And usually a point guard knocked down free throws. Kara gets the second one to fall. His minutes have been increasing throughout the course of the year. Columbia goes up by 5, their largest lead of the game. Beckton works to the right. He kicks it out to the high post to Stephen Hawkins out of Cape Coral, Florida. Right side, Beckton driving baseline. Shot blocked by Davis. Kara brings it up near sideline. Crosses over, top the key. Left side, Colin Parker going strong on the rack. Head fake, shot up and in. Colin Parker with his second basket. 18-11. Cougars on a bit of a run here. 6-0 run for Columbia. Make it 8-0. 8-0 run for the Cougars. With the dribble on the left side, Becton. Stephen Hawkins from Patrick Henry Community College. Now to Brown. Hawkins. Back out top to Brown. Brown shot on the way. Good. Wynn Brown Jr. now has 5 points. He's out of Bartlett High School in Memphis. 18-13. That ended an 8-0 run. Tommy Hafer kicks it down low to Colin Parker, who goes strong to the bucket, scores, and he's fouled. Called for the foul is Becton. It'll be his first. Second team foul. Give the bucket to Colin Parker, who's now got 6 points. Colin Parker now shooting 67% from the free throw line on the year. We'll try to complete the three-point play. Colin Parker, 6'7", sophomore. This guy's shooting well from everywhere. Free throw is good. Got 7 points. Colin had 21 to lead the Cougars on Tuesday against C of O. But Colin Parker shooting 51% from the floor, 39% from the three-point arc. He's just a sophomore, true sophomore. On the move around the top, Hawkins. Hawkins tied up. Kicks it off to the left side. Gets the ball to Jones. Jones drives down to the baseline. Can't get a shot out of there. Gets it to the top of the key. Hawkins shot no good. Colin Parker with a rebound. Colin Parker with the second rebound of the game. Kara. Kicks it off to the right side to Burks. Down low Carson Parker to Colin Parker from the wing. Three-pointer short. Carson Parker with the rebound. He'll give the Burks for an open look. That's no good. Carson Parker with another rebound to Colin Parker to Kara for a three. That one will go. As Kara Parker now has four. Cougars pounded the boards on that trip down. Coleman with a dribble out top. Works to the right. Gets it to Nugent. Nugent to Brown. Brown, jump shot, no good. Rebound, Colin Parker. Brown comes in, averaging 10 points, 4 rebounds a game. He's one of their scorers. Carson Parker, back it in. Reverse layup, he got it. Carson Parker gets the reverse layup. The Cougars have opened up a 26-13 lead as Columbia has a 13-point advantage. Timeout called by Webster. Cougar fans, for every three-pointer that's made between every three-pointer that is made by the men and the women this year, the men and women's teams, Downtown Appliance Home Center will donate $3 towards the fight against cancer. 168 three-pointers have been made coming into today's action for a total of $504. The Cougars are on pace to raise $1,900 for the season. Three-pointer hit just moments ago by Marlon Allen. Three-pointer by Kara. So add those three-pointers to the total, as they've now made 170 three-point shots. Cougars trying to improve on their 9-4 record. It's another NCAA Division III team. The other team they saw from this level was Westminster. Of course, they're in the same league, playing in the St. Louis Intercollegiate Athletic Conference, along with Fontbonne and Principia. To name a few. A 13-point lead for Columbia. As Jason Coleman back out there, brings it up the floor against Kara. Bounces it to the high post, gets the ball to Nate Jones. Jones with it at the elbow, backs away. Brown fires it in the corner to the elbow. Picking up the dribble and back to Jones. Step back shot, no good. And a push on the rebound against Marlon Allen. Marlon Allen called for the foul to be his first. Second foul on the Cougars. We played 10 and a half minutes and there's been four fouls called in the game. Four turnovers. Webster's turned it over four times, Columbia once. Cougars using that size advantage. They've been pounding the boards. Columbia is now rebounding Webster 9-6. Tisdale gets it out top to Kara. Kara catches the screen. Now to Tisdale. Tisdale works the ball out to Carson Parker. Tisdale in the corner. His shot good. That's the second trade for Tisdale in this game. Cougars push their lead to 16 here in the first half. Nugent puts it on the floor a couple times. Out of Jamaica. Nugent with a jump stop, shot up short, rebound popped loose. Picked up by Marlon Allen. Allen leaves it for Kara. Now, timeout called as Kara has been cut above the eye or near the eye. And Kenny Seifert says, son, you can't be playing like that. We're going to get you patched up. So he stops the game. And Tony Burks will check in. Lucas Green, our lead camera operator, probably got a good shot of that. I'm not sure when the be a laceration, correct? When that would have taken place. Bringing it into the front court, Tisdale. Tisdale almost has it stolen by Brown. Gets it back down low. Carson Parker one-on-one. Kicks it back out. Allen to Carson, and Carson lays it in. Carson Parker at 7 points against CMO on Tuesday. He's got six already this afternoon. Brown kicks it out top to Becton. Around the horn. To the left side it goes to Luster. Brown Jr. with it. Coleman out top, Nugent. His shot on the way. It's good as it rolled in. Javon Nugent now with 4 points. 31-15. Man-to-man defense by Webster. They're playing out their top player and Carl Moore Jr. out of Jennings, Missouri, a freshman. Carson Parker with another bucket. This one off the left block. Now he's got eight. Nugent kicks it in the corner to Coleman. Out to Becton. Becton backing away. Lost the dribble. Boyer is guarding him. As Justin Boyer's checked into the game from Father Tolton High School. In the corner to Brown. Nugent. Nugent shot good. Yvonne Nugent comes into the game. Averaging 5 points and five rebounds. He's got six this afternoon. 33-17. Webster pulls back to within 14 points. This 3-point is good for Marlon Allen. Marlon Allen came in shooting just 11% from the arc, and he's drained two today. 36-17. Cougar lead back at 19. In the corner, Nugent for another one. No good. Rebound, Burks. Burks brings it up, launches a three. It's no good. And Carson Parker's going to be called for being out of control. Carson called for the foul. It's his second personal foul, third team foul. Mass substitution for both teams. Nate Jones checks in. Also checking back in is Josh Luster. Colin Parker in for Carson Parker. Tommy Hafer back out there along with Brock Davis. Tommy's dad, Jeff, here at the ballpark today. watching his son play all the way up from Joplin. I bet there's another game he'll watch later today. With it on the right wing, Becton. Becton drives to the baseline, tied up by Colin Parker. Out to Jones, and Jones walked with the ball. Yeah, Jeff Hafer played for Norm Stewart and the Missouri Tigers across town. And today the Tigers have a big game. Well, kind of. They play Kansas later this afternoon. Tisdale works to the left side. Colin Parker. Down low to Burks. Burks drives into the paint. Turnaround shot out of the paint. No good. Rebound Davis. Put back Davis. No good. Got his own rebound. Put it back up. That's no good. And a whistle and a foul. Called for the personals. Nate Jones. It'll be his first. Fourth team foul now on Webster. Davis to the stripe. Free throw on the way, good. Brock Davis, the freshman from Holland Hall High School. Comes into the game shooting his 45% from the free throw line. He is a true freshman, 6'6". Made both free throws. And he's now shooting 2-2 today from the stripe. 4 points today in the game. With a dribble to the right side, Coleman. He kicks it in the corner to Becton. Becton down low to Sykes. Sykes kicks it in the corner. Long threes. Good out of the left corner by Luster. The transfer from Mineral Area. 38-20. Cougars by 18. Davis works right side, Hafer down low, Colin Parker left wide open. He lays it in. Colin Parker now with 9 points, and the Gorlocks want a timeout as they want to talk it over. We'll take a break. 5:05 to play first half, Cougars by 20.
When my family opened the first Culver's in Sauk City, Wisconsin, you know what we did? We gave it our all, making sure everyone felt welcome. Sharing our favorite foods from around the state, like butter burgers and fresh frozen custard. Greeting every guest with all our heart. Crafting each meal with care. Leaving a smile makes everything taste better. And it's a tradition we bring with us yet today, from our hometown to yours. Welcome to Delicious.
Appliance is celebrating 60 years. Our secret? Happy customers.
Choosing Downtown Appliance for us wasn't even really a question.
I never feel like I'm hung out to dry when I'm dealing with Downtown Appliance.
Accessibility, knowledge, expertise.
I think they're amazing.
They're not happy until I'm happy.
If anyone asks me where they should get appliances, I would definitely tell them Downtown Appliance.
It's our go-to.
Celebrate 60 years with Downtown Appliance Home Center, East Broadway.
Columbia 40, the Gorlocks of Webster 20 with 5:01 to play first half. This will be our last stream of the year here from the Cougar Dome. Next time we talk to you will be on the first day of 2023. If we can get Tim Fox on his feet by 1 o'clock or so, as the Columbia women will be here at home. And we'll have that action for you. Gorlocks with the ball. Bringing it out to the top to Kia's Luster. Luster kicks it off to the left side to Coleman. Becton knocks down an 18-footer. Marcus Becton now with 8 points in the game, and he has been nailing that mid-range jumper. Left side, Colin Parker. Davis, right side, Burks. Down low to Colin Parker. Man-to-man defense by the Gorlocks. They sag in that man. Colin Parker with a spin move now has 11 first half points. Coleman works it to the right side. Picked up by Tisdale. Columbia's been in a man throughout this first half. Becton, another mid-range jumper. This one's short. Rebound tipped up and in by Jamard Sykes the second. That's Sykes' first basket of the game. He comes in averaging 8 points per contest. five rebounds. Well, that was a rebound and a bucket. Feed down low to Davis, and that's broken up. And they got a foul on the play. Called for the foul. Sykes. That'll be his first 15 foul. Well, the Gorlocks opened the year against Illinois College. Lost that one 61-45. That's a Division III club. And then Wisconsin-Stevens Point, they lost 80-47. They got their clock clean. And then Yeshiva knocked them off 75-58. Out of the corner, Tisdale's three is no good. Rebound Burks, he's fouled underneath. Then they played Wash U, lost that 53-52. Of course, Wash U's a D3 program. Then they fell to Central Iowa, lost to DePaul, lost to Monmouth, Illinois. Free throw on the way from Burks is good. Tony Burks now with 4 points. Next free throw from the All-Americans, also good. He's got five. Hit 15 against C of O. Anyhow, they finally beat Millsaps on the 4th of December. The Gorlocks did. And then they knocked off Williams Baptist 72-73 on Thursday. Long three on the way is nothing but net by Nate Jones out of Wallace State Community College. And they're playing today without Carl Moore Jr. Had 15 points in that win against Williams Baptist. Colin Parker double team gives to Marlon Allen, and they're going to call Marlon Allen for walk. Cougars turn it over. It's turnover number two for Columbia. 2:45 to play, first half. Out top, Nugent. Driving, reverse layup, won't go for Brown. Rebound, Colin Parker. He now has three boards. All the way down the middle, Tisdale, and he hits the runner. Tisdale now with 8 points. Pass out top to Nugent. Nugent works left side to Becton. Becton trying to slither his way to the bucket, walk with the ball. And that's the fifth turnover now, charged to Webster. Cougars have established themselves, have a 20-point lead here early in the game. Burks down low to Colin Parker, and he scores. Colin Parker is like a machine. 13 points now in the first half. Cougars by 21. Right side, Brown. Brown catches a screen from Becton, then lobs it out top. Gets the ball to Sykes. Left side, three-point shot. No, Nugent missed a two-point attempt. Colin Parker with another rebound. They're starting to mount up. Burks has it. Burks drives to the basket, reverse layup, no good. Rebound boarded down by Luster. Luster to the rack. Shot partially deflected, maybe by Colin Parker. Definitely altered. It's no good. Rebound, Allen. Carson Parker to Colin. Into the corner. Tisdale for three. No. Rebound loose on the deck. Carson Parker to Colin for three. Good. Colin Parker's got 16. 51-27. Cougars push their lead to 24. On the left side, Sykes. Now to the right side to Brown. Down low, Nugent. Nugent being guarded by Carson Parker. Nugent driving baseline. Slides underneath. Carson Parker blocks it. Colin Parker cleans it up. Gets it over to Burks. Under him, half a minute to play. 20 seconds to play in the first half. Cougars leading by 24 at the moment. Tisdale right side. Out top to Burks. 7 seconds. Burks catches a double pick, drives down to the left side. Shot blocked by Becton, and then the outlet's intercepted by Brown. From 75 feet, it's no good, and we play to half. And here at the break, the Columbia Cougars with a 24-point advantage. Cougars 51. The Gorlocks of Webster University 27. We're at the half, and we'll be back with the Hawthorne Bank Halftime Show in a moment. This is Columbia Cougar Basketball.
Culver's couldn't have started anywhere but in Sauk City, Wisconsin. Still today, we are a family restaurant. Here, nearby farms grow the food we eat, smiles are contagious, and everyone is someone's neighbor. It's a place where our love of fresh food is as strong as our love for each other. It's a feeling of welcome you'll notice the moment you stop by. Because where we come from has made us who we are. And for that, we couldn't be more proud. Welcome to Delicious.
Hey, you said we need carpet, right?
Well, honey, we need more than carpet. We need carpet for the bedroom, tile for the bathroom, and hard surface flooring for the kitchen and living room.
Wow. So they really do more than carpet.
Yep, that's why they're called Carpet One Floor and Home. They'll help us select the best flooring for our needs.
I think these guys said they do that too.
Guys?
So let's talk fiber. Fiber internet. Fiber internet transfers data via fiber optic cables, which means fiber internet is over 100 times faster than DSL. It's far more reliable, too. There's no interference from electrical equipment, weather, or other complications. Fiber currently delivers speeds up to 1 gigabit per second. So if your household streams TV and movies, downloads music and videos, plays online video games, has multiple devices connected to Wi-Fi, you need Socket Fiber. Ditch the DSL and switch to Socket. Call 1-800-SOCKET3.
Since 1929, we've been here to serve our communities with the best products and the best service. You are the reason we go to work every day, and we thank you for that. After all, we live where you do.
Get $50 off a Hy-Vee Plus premium membership with code Mahomes.
Since 1929, we've been here to serve our communities with the best products and the best service. You are the reason we go to work every day. And we thank you for that. After all, we live where you do.
Cougars dominate the first half here at Columbia College. Welcome back to the Southwell Complex here in Columbia for the Hawthorne Bank Halftime Show. At the break, Columbia with a commanding 51-27 lead. 51-27, Cougars with the lead as they have been all over Webster. And the big stat that stands out, Columbia's out rebounded Webster 20-9. Cougars with 20 rebounds, 6 of them offensive. Webster 9 rebounds. They have 2 offensive rebounds. Webster's turned the ball over 6 times here in the first half. And Columbia's turned it over 3 times. Cougars shot 58% from the floor. They were 19-33 in the first half. Columbia was 7-14 from the arc for 50%, 86% from the free throw line, 6-7. Webster shot 1 free throw and missed it. Webster was 12 of 27 from the floor for 44%. They shot 43% from the three-point line. They were 3 of 7. Webster had 7 assists. Columbia had 9 assists in that game in the first half. Top scorer for Webster in the first half was Marcus Beckman with 8 points and a rebound. 6 points, 3 rebounds for Javon Nugent. 5 points for Wayne Brown. 2 points, 3 rebounds for Jamar Sykes. And 3 points for Nate Jones and Josh Luster. Top scorer in the first half for the Cougars was our second player of the game on Tuesday night, Colin Parker. Collins got 18 points and 5 rebounds, 1 assist here in the first half. His brother, Carson Parker, I have him for 8 points, but they say he only has 6. 6 points for Carson Parker, 3 rebounds, 4 assists. 6 points, 2 rebounds for Marlon Allen. 5 points, 4 rebounds for Tony Burks. 4 points for Dodo Kara and 4 points, 4 rebounds for Brock Davis. As the Cougars just totally commanding the first half, 51-27 is the score here at the half. And that is your Hawthorne Bank halftime show statistics. When we return, we'll have more for you here at Columbia College. This is Cougar basketball.
Your voice lets him know he's safe. Shelter Insurance does the same for you. Roadside assistance provided by Road America is now included with your auto policy. We'll take care of you while you take care of what's most important. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
Downtown Appliance is celebrating 60 years. Our secret? Happy customers.
I had experiences with a number of people at Downtown Appliance, all of which were beyond my expectations in terms of kindness, understanding, being good listeners. They are incredibly friendly, and they heard me in terms of what I wanted and what my expectations were and are, and they've met and exceeded those.
Celebrate 60 years with Downtown Appliance Home Center, East Broadway.
To everyone who loves great food, let us make you a meal the Wisconsin way.
We cook each butter burger to order for you and the people you love, so it's the best part of your day.
The best.
The best. And every creamy scoop of fresh frozen custard, pure happiness.
Pure happiness.
Pure happiness. Because where Culver's comes from,
in the heart of America's Dairyland.
Our love.
Our love for fresh food is as strong as our love for all of you.
From Wisconsin with love.
Welcome to Delicious. Yeah.
Don't have time for car maintenance? No need to interrupt your day. Have Lee's Tire Mobile Express come to you. Now delivering hassle-free service in a state-of-the-art van equipped for on-the-spot oil changes, tire repairs, tire installation, tire rotations, and balancing. Enjoy the convenience of having the same quality workmanship as the last 50 years brought to your door. Call or visit us online to book an appointment with Lee's Tire Mobile Express. Now serving your location.
Advanced Radiology knows life is full of struggles caused by accidents or from the pains of aging. You'll feel comfortable from the moment you arrive in our convenient Circle Drive. Just a short walk to the front desk. Always assisted in a clean, caring environment. Advanced Radiology charges less than most hospitals and offers same-day reporting. You'll know your charges up front and get only one bill. Remember, you can choose where you go for diagnostics. Tell your doctor, Advanced Radiology.
Whether your car has small tires, big tires, tires that go fast, tires with extra grip, or tires that just get you from here to there, they can be an unexpected expense. Don't wait any longer. At Big O Tires, we have no credit needed financing available. So no matter your budget, no matter your situation, we have the lowest prices on every kind of tire every day. With multiple lending partners, our financing is tailored to you. Don't wait another day. Take advantage of our no credit needed financing only at Big O Tires.
This is how legends are made.
The Hawthorne Bank halftime show rolls on here at the Cougar Dome. 51-27, Columbia with a 24-point lead against Webster. Tomorrow, the Columbia women's basketball team is in action, but they're on the road. They're down in Phoenix, Arizona, and they take on the Lopes from Grand Canyon University. And that will be an exhibition contest. Actually, it's a 2 o'clock Central Time start, and you can actually see that game live on ESPN+. That's tomorrow as James Arnold's women's team on the road as they play an exhibition game. The women's team will be back home as they take on the University of St. Mary on January the 1st. That's actually a 1 o'clock start for the women's team on January the 1st. They play at Grand Canyon tomorrow. Then on their return, they stop off at Nevada, Missouri to take on Cotty College, a newcomer to the league. That'll be a league game for the women. That's on Thursday the 15th. And then on Saturday, they'll travel with them in to Missouri Baptist to wrap up first half, first semester play to take on Missouri Baptist. Couple of big games in St. Louis next Saturday in the AMC as the Missouri or the Columbia College women take on Missouri Baptist, and then the men will play. That's a 1 o'clock start with the women on this upcoming Saturday, a week from today. The men will not be home until the 7th of January when they entertain our friends from William Woods. The Owls will be here. That's a doubleheader with the men, with the women. The women will start at 1 on that Saturday, the January the 7th, and then at 3 o'clock, the men will play William Woods. And Woods is one of those teams that's coming on strong in the league right now as they're getting their ducks in a row. Here at the half, the Columbia men, in a non-conference game, leads Webster 51-27. We'll be back with the second half after these words. This is Columbia Cougar basketball.
Your voice lets him know he's safe. Shelter Insurance does the same for you. Roadside assistance provided by Road America is now included with your auto policy. We'll take care of you.
Thank you.
While you take care of what's most important. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
Downtown Appliance is celebrating 60 years. Our secret? Happy customers.
I had experiences with a number of people at Downtown Appliance, all of which were beyond my expectations in terms of kindness, understanding, being good listeners. They are incredibly friendly, and they heard me in terms of what I wanted and what my expectations were and are, and they've met and exceeded those.
Celebrate 60 years with Downtown Appliance Home Center, East Broadway.
To everyone who loves great food, let us make you a meal the Wisconsin way.
We cook each Butterburger to order for you and the people you love, so it's the best part of your day.
The best.
The best.
And every creamy scoop of fresh frozen custard, pure happiness.
Pure happiness.
Pure happiness. Because where Culver's comes from,
and the heart of America's Dairyland.
Our love.
Our love for fresh food is as strong as our love for all of you.
From Wisconsin with love.
Welcome to Delicious.
Don't have time for car maintenance? No need to interrupt your day. Have Lee's Tire Mobile Express come to you. Now delivering hassle-free service in a state-of-the-art van equipped for on-the-spot oil changes, tire repairs, tire installation, tire rotations, and balancing. Enjoy the convenience of having the same quality workmanship as the last 50 years brought to your door. Call or visit us online to book an appointment with Lee's Tire Mobile Express. Now serving your location.
Pop was here last week. He was talking about Brooklyn and the place Brooklyn was at, how they were really, like, thriving right now. But he was, you know, he was trying to pull people up with him. And he wasn't even to where he was about to be. He just was trying to, he was trying to get, I mean, he was on his, he was well on his way. It's just tragic. 20 years old, rest in peace, God bless Pop Smoke.
Look. Mama made it. Mama made it.
Mama, I made it. Thank God that I made it. Mama, I made it, we made it. Look, mama, I made it. Look, I remember the days. Same bitch for a week straight. I used to eat 50 cent cake. Now it's for leaps. It's for leaps for the state.
51-27, that's the score as we get set for the second half. The Columbia Cougars entertaining Webster. Columbia dominating that first half, giving up 27 points. This past Tuesday, they gave up just 19 to C of O. Webster will get the ball to start the second half as Jamard Sykes II will kick it inbounds to Brown. And Brown gets it out top to Javon Nugent. Back to Brown on the right side. Wynn Brown fires up from the top of the key. A two-pointer. It's no good. And the rebound boarded down by Tisdale. Columbia into the front court. As Tisdale gets to Allen. And Allen's pass is deflected out of bounds. By Sykes. Tisdale to trigger along the baseline. Burks, who's been quiet here tonight, or this afternoon, gets a down low to Carson Parker to Burks for a three out of the corner. No good. Allen with a rebound. He missed the putback. And this rebound ran down by Sykes. Sykes gets it up the floor to Coleman moving in against Colin Parker. That shot no good, but Colin Parker will be called for a block. Foul on Colin Parker is his first. First foul in the second half on either club, and that'll send Coleman to the line. Coleman, a 71% free throw shooter, hasn't scored in the game, and he'll get two tries here from the 15-foot mark. Coleman's free throw, it's good. Total of six fouls called on Webster in the first half. Columbia was called for two. Not many fouls called at all. Coleman got both free throws. Coleman from Overton High School. He's a junior. 6 foot, 162 out of Memphis. Cougar lead, cut to 22. Tisdale, Carson Parker, ain't a man defense. Tisdale down low, Colin Parker. Tisdale around the horn, Allen for a three, no good. Rebound, Carson Parker to Colin, and he'll throw it down. Colin Parker now with 18 points. Left side, Jones for a three, and he splashed it down. Rather, that's Sykes. Sykes with that basket. 53-32. Burks with it on the right side. Webster playing man-to-man and a holding call down low. Going against the Gorlocks. Called for the foul is Marcus Becton. It'll be his second. First foul on Webster in the second half. Carson Parker. Allen. Turned it over. But only momentarily as Wynn Brown ran out of room on that far sideline. Tony Burks to pass it, or to inbound the ball, or attempt to. Gets it into Tisdale. Webster still trying to play tenacious man-to-man defense. Allen with it on the right side, down low Colin Parker. Brown down low to strip it out of there and make the steal. Brown gets it up the floor to Coleman. Coleman's shot is blocked by Burke. They're going to call Burke for a foul. Tony Burke's called for the foul. It'll be his first. Second foul on the Cougars in the second half, and they've tied the first half total. Actually, I had the Cougars for three first half fouls. His free throw on the way is good from Coleman, who is now 3 of 3 from the line. He's averaging 11 points, 3 rebounds a game. He's been quiet in this one. Spent a lot of time on the bench in that first half. Coleman's next free throw is good. 4 points here today, all from the line. And it's a 19-point Cougar lead. Tisdale catches a screen for Carson Parker. Now to Burks. Burks to Tisdale. Tisdale drives the left side of the lane. Shot short off target, or was it a pass to Allen? Allen pulled it down, stuck it up and in. Allen now with 8 points, rather 6 points. 8 points, 8 points for Allen. He's hit a couple trays. Becton spins into the lane, open for the shot, missed it, rebound, Colin Parker. Colin Parker with 5 boards. Tisdale drives, floater on the way, no good, rebound Allen. Allen's kind of been the cleanup man inside. His putback won't go down. Carson Parker has the lead. He kicks, has the rebound. Out to Colin for a three. That won't go down. Rebound ran down by Brown up the floor to Coleman, who lays it in. Coleman with 6 points, and Thomas Brock wants a timeout. No, a foul. Foul in the backcourt. Wynn Brown called for the foul. It'll be his first. Second team foul now on Webster. 55-36, Cougars by 19. 3 minutes, 8 seconds gone, second half. Left side, Colin Parker. Carson Parker out top. Right side now to Burks. Burks to Carson Parker. A little out of his range. Drives into the paint. Puts up the shot off the glass. No good. Rebound poured it down by Sykes. Jamar Sykes. No look pass inside Nugent. Kicks it back out to Coleman. It falls into Sykes' hands and he lays it in. Sykes now with 7. And the Cougar lead is cut to 17. And Thomas Brock now calls a timeout. Timeout Cougars, 55-38. Columbia with the lead, but they're sputtering to start the second half. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Since 1929, we've been here to serve our communities with the best products and the best service. You are the reason we go to work every day, and we thank you for that. After all, we live where you do.
Cougars lead at 55-38, but their big advantage has been whittled down. They were up 24 at the break. Thomas Brock called a timeout, tried to get his club back on the rails. Big difference in this game. Cougars have 28 points in the paint. Webster has 10. That goes with the difference in size of these two clubs. Tony Burks drives baseline. Reverse layup score. Burks with 7 points. 57-38. Columbia. Brown. Left side, Becton. Left corner, Sykes. Back out to Wynn Brown, Jr. He'll fire from in 19 feet. It's no good. Rebound, Nugent, no good. Davis with the next rebound. Burks brings it up the floor. Burks alley-oops it up, but no one was home. He thought Davis was going to the hole. Davis late to read it. And a reverse layup by Becton is good. And Becton now in double figures with 10. 17-point Columbia lead. Tisdale, right side, gives to Burks. Back to Tisdale in front of Thomas Brock. Tisdale at the free throw line. Down low, Colin Parker. Bank shot, Colin Parker. Scored. Colin Parker with 20 points here in this game. 59-40. Sykes kicks it in the corner to Coleman, driving baseline. Coleman shot blocked by Brock Davis. Brock Davis just picked up the foul. The foul on Brock Davis is his first. Third team foul on the Cougars. Another shooting foul. As Jason Coleman out of Memphis to the line, where he is 4-4 today, making 5-5. Gorlocks as a team come in shooting 58% from the free throw line. but not Coleman. He's perfect, 5 of 5. 6 of 6. And he has 8 points. 59-42. Kara with that big bandage over his right eye kicks it down low to Colin Parker, to Kara in the corner. Tommy Hafer for a three. That won't go. Brown with a rebound. He brings it up the floor. In the corner, Coleman. Columbia playing man-to-man, sagging just a bit. Brown spinning around in the corner, guarded by Burks. Now out top it comes to Becton. Back to Brown. Brown penetrates. The runner blocked by Burks. Good defensive stand by Columbia. Burks brings it back. Burks strong to the rack, splits the double team and scores. Burks has 9. Cougars back by 19. Boyer will check in next opportunity. Remember, Columbia's playing without Bowl Washer. Cole Gerken's not. Well, he's available, but they didn't know how much he'd play today. He is in uniform. Into the paint, left-hand shot put up and missed. Missing out was Nate Jones. And Hafer has the rebound. Cougars by 19. Trying to win their 10th game of the year. Colin Parker, no-look pass inside to Molina. Rather, Brock Davis, and he flushes it down. Brock Davis with 6, the 6'6 freshman. Got a great pass. Cougars by 21. Offensive foul on Wynn Brown Jr. Webster playing without Carl Moore Jr. He's averaged 9.9 rebounds a game. The 6'4", 215-pounder out of Jennings was injured at practice earlier this week. Not available today. The foul on Wynn Brown Jr. is his second, both of them in the second half. Cougars by 21 with the ball. Man-to-man defense by Webster. Kara with it on the perimeter. Kicks it off to Boyer. Boyer, the freshman, back out top to Burks. Burks down the left side of the lane. Tried to make an underhand pass over to Davis, and it was knocked away. 13 minutes to play in this one. Boyer has it at the left elbow. Drives to the paint. Puts up Figueroa shot. No good. Hafer battle on the boards. Davis has got it. And Davis scores. Brock Davis with 4 points in the second half. 8 points in the game. Becton shot on the way. No good. Boyer with a rebound. Here come the Cougars. Kara down the far sideline. Kara bounces it over to Davis and stripped away by Nate Jones and out of bounds. And it goes off of Brock Davis. Nate Jones, 6'5", 200-pounder out of Huntsville, Alabama. Went to Wallace State. Hafer has it. Out top. Long shot from Boyer is good. Boyer missed one of those three-point attempts earlier, but he got this one to fall. High arcing rainbow shot. 68-42. Just like that, the Cougars are up 26. They have their biggest lead of the game. Becton on the perimeter, guarded by Boyer. Becton makes a nice pass. Backdoor cut made and finished by Nate Jones as he lays it in. 68-44, full court pressure applied by Brown. Kara gets it up the floor. The little guy's doing battle. Burks with it on the right wing. Hafer had the 18-footer, passed on it. Hafer kicks it out to Burks. Burks fouled by Coleman. Coleman thought he had position. First foul on Coleman. Fourth foul now on Webster. Stephen Hawkins, a 6'2 senior, checks in out of Cape Coral, Florida. Or Webster, also checking in for Webster, is Mark Moore out of Hillsboro, Missouri. along with Josh Luster. Kara has it out top, works to the left. Bounce it down low to Carson Parker. His shot is no good. Rebound Jones. Webster will bring it up. Luster. Sykes, left side, Hawkins, three-pointer, Hawkins, good. Stephen Hawkins hits the three. He's only shooting 12% out there, but he made that one. His percentage probably just doubled. Carson Parker to Boyer, down the middle, Boyer missed it. Rebound Kara to Boyer, Boyer strung the rack. That won't go, no whistle. Rebound cleared down by Webster. With it on the left side, Sykes, skip pass. Down to Nate Jones. Jones shot blocked by Carson Parker. Burks brings it up the floor. Round Hawkins to the basket, score. Burks with 11. Cougars push their lead back to 23. Luster with the ball, guarded by Allen. Downloaded Nate Jones. Jones kicks it out top. Gets the ball to Luster. His runner won't go. Carson Parker with a rebound. He thought he was a guard. He's going to dribble it down the floor. Kara into the front court. Kara to the basket. Missed it. Rebound out of bounds. It'll be Webster's ball. We make the turn here at the three-quarter mark. The Cougars with a 70-47 lead. Timeout called by the Gorlocks as they want to talk things over. As the Gorlocks call a timeout. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Family first. My dad used to tell us that all the time. But family first wasn't just something he'd say to us. It was how he lived every day of his life. And it's how I try to live mine too.
At Shelter Insurance, our agents are dedicated to helping provide personalized auto, home, and life protection that puts your family first. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
70-47, all Cougars. Columbia trying to get another win here at home. Columbia has played a pretty heavy home schedule at this point of the year. They've been very good at home. Into the front court. Sykes, he dishes it out to Jones. Jones lays it in, and Jones is fouled. Called for the foul is Dodo Kara. Fourth team foul, and to the line goes Nate Jones. Jones, who's seen limited action, knocks down the free throw. He's a 6'5 sophomore. Jones now with 8 points in the game. Kara circles around the top, left elbow, out top to Carson Parker. Collin posted up, back to Carson. He'll fire a three. Won't go. And the rebound cleared down by Nate Jones. Carson Parker's now 0-2 from three-point territory this year. This three-point shot by Jones is by Sykes, no good. Rebound Collin Parker, lead pass to Allen. He lets traffic clear and scores. Marlon Allen with 10 points. 72-50, Columbia. Cougars by 22. Hawkins kicks it out. Gets it out top to Jones. Nate tied up, to Luster. Luster works it over to Moore. Moore out of the paint, puts up a leaner and got it. Mark Moore out of Hillsboro, Missouri. 72-52. He was fading away, hit that shot. Kara drives off. Gives it to Collin Parker for a three. That won't go. Carson with a rebound. Carson Parker kicks it off to Kara in the corner. And Kara called for being out of bounds. Tommy Hafer, Tony Burks, and Brock Davis checks in for the Cougars. 8:08 to play. And here come the Gorlocks. Moore bounces it off to Jones, to Sykes. Sykes being chased by Burks. Now top. Hawkins. Hawkins can shoot the three. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Hawkins tied up. Now to Jones. He lets traffic clear. Fires the three. It's no good. Rebound Hafer. Outlets it to Burks. Burks out of the hoops at the Davis for the dunk. Nicely executed. Hafer with a nice pass to Burks, and Burks with the alley-oop to Davis for the dunk. Didn't get much prettier than that. 74-52 Cougars. Luster has it knocked free. Loose basketball. Hafer gets on the floor and ties it up. Tommy playing in front of his dad today. Coach Hafer from Joplin. Retired, I might say. 74-52. Cougars get the ball on the hustle. Out top Davis, left side Burks. Burks drives into the paint. This is a no-looker off to Hafer, who finishes it. Tommy Hafer with his first basket of the game. 76-52. Cougars again by 24. Both teams still playing hard, even though this one's pretty well decided. On the move, Sykes. Sykes fouled. He was clobbered. Played by Brock Davis. Davis called for the foul to be his second. Nugent over there cleaning things up. Batteries visiting with the Cougar Dance Squad. Might be doing both. 76-54. 6.5 minutes to play. Give the basket to Sykes. He's now got 9. He'll try to complete the 3-point play. Missed the shot. Davis with a rebound. Davis, right side, Burks. Burks into the paint, kicks it out. Shot on the way, Tisdale, no good. Rebound ran down by Sykes, and here come the Gorlocks into the front court. Becton driving underneath. And driving underneath was Coleman. Brock Davis got up in the air, and a high-low collision. It looks like Davis going to be all right. And it looks like also Coleman all right. Davis called for the foul. Davis down with 3 fouls in the game. 16th foul now on Columbia. Foul occurred on the deck. No shot. Right side, Sykes the second. He kicks it down low. Gets it to Nugent. Nugent spinning on Davis. Back out top to Coleman. In the corner, Becton. Guarded by Boyer. Becton slides through the paint. A semi-hook shot good for Becton. Becton now with 12 points in the game. 3 above his average. And Trendon Tisdale, who averages 10 points a game, gets it across the line to Boyer. Davis, right side Burks, playing without the Parker brothers right now. Now Hafer. Hafer had the 3, passed it. Gives the ball to Tisdale. Tisdale to Boyer, a lot of contact inside. Burks with it on the right block. Spins in the paint, head fake to the basket, score, just beating the shot clock. Burks is 13. 78-56 Columbia. Cougars with a 22-point lead. Becton backs out beyond the arc. Drives into the lane. Head fake. Basket by Coleman. Hafer almost fouled him. Coleman now with double figures. He's got 10 all in the second half. Webster doing a good job of getting the ball inside despite that height disadvantage. Pass down low to Davis. Here's it stolen by Sykes. Sykes to Brown. Sykes for a three. Score. Jamar Sykes now with 12 points. 6-2 freshman. 78-61. Man-to-man defense by Webster. Cougars will call a timeout with 4-4 play. We've got a break. We'll be back with more here at Columbia College in a moment.
Wondering, what is Socket Fiber? Socket Fiber is the fastest, most reliable internet service available in mid-Missouri. So, how do I get Socket Fiber at my house? First, check to see if you currently have Socket Fiber to your home by going to socket.net/fiberhood and checking your address. If Socket does not have fiber currently available to your home, just go to socket.net/fiberhood to request it to your home. Request Socket Fiber today and become the next Fiberhood.
...78-61 Columbia, 4 minutes to play in the game. Boyer with it on the left point. Backs away from the pressure of the Gorlocks. I think Gorlocks may have switched to his own, 2-3. Skip pass out to Hafer. 2 seconds on the shot clock. Tisdale launches. No good. Rebound Davis to Boyer. Boyer going to be called for out of control in the paint. Justin Boyer picks up his first foul of the day. Player control foul. That's 17 foul, but no shooting because of player control foul. And back come the Gorlocks. You don't run into Gorlocks every day. On the move, Brown circling around, caught a screen. Kicks it out to Sykes for a three, no good. Davis with another rebound. Davis now with 8 rebounds in the game. Boyer for another tray, no good. Cole Gerken out there for the first time today. First time this week. He gets the rebound, playing with that injured shoulder. Now a whistle away from the ball, and it's going to go against Wynn Brown, Jr.
Foul on
the
Gorlocks.
Third foul on Brown. It'll be his third foul of the second half, third foul in the game. Fifth team foul now on Webster. Davis catches the inbounds pass. Hafer, Marlon Allen, and he finished it with a roll. Allen with a dozen. Stick around our postgame show. We'll visit with Thomas Brock. Get his thoughts on today's game and maybe take a peek at that game at Mo Bapp. You know, Mo Bapp is 4-0 in the league. Columbia is 2-1. That's going to be a huge game. The Cougars want to pick up some ground. Nugent drives into the paint, puts up a shot. No good. Nugent with a rebound. That shot blocked by Allen. Nugent flying all over the place. Allen just reaches over and commits a foul. Foul on Marlon Allen is his second. Eighth team foul now on the Cougars. Nugent's free throw is no good. Nugent's a senior. Saw a lot of action last year. Averaging 6 points, 5 boards a game. He's got 6, all in the first half today. Listed at 6'2", 195-pounder out of Jamaica. And Javon Nugent makes the second free throw. Tisdale into the front court. Drives to the baseline. Banks it up. That's no good. Rebound. Coleman to Brown. Boy, Brown's quick as a hiccup. Has it along the left baseline. Kicks it back out top. Gets it to Beckham. That shot no good. Rebound tipped around. And Cole Gerken's got one. As Gerken will bring it back. 2 minutes to play in the game. Marlon Allen strong with the basket. Left hand scored. Allen with 14 points. One of his top offensive outputs of the year. Had a big game, I believe, down at CBC. Out top, on the move, Coleman to Brown. Brown catches a screen, kicks it off to Sykes for a three, off the mark, rebound. Pulled down by Nugent. Out to Brown. That shot missed the rim, so there's 1 second on the shot clock. That shot on the rim saved him. Won't go in. Rebound Columbia. Tisdale fights through. Gets it up the floor to Hafer. Hafer to Tisdale. Gerken on the left side for a long three short. And the rebound falls into the hands of Becton. Under a minute to play in this one. Cougars going to improve to 10-4. Allen with a block. Lead pass up the court to Davis. And he'll miss the dunk. Rebound out of bounds. And the Cougars are going to their bench. As Luka Ikovic will check in for Columbia. Also, Zavon Ward checks in for the Cougars as well. They get on the court for the first time. Allen checks out. Tisdale's done for the day. Warlocks will bring it up the floor. Differential of about 9 seconds. Game clock, shot clock. Into the left corner, Becton. Becton tied up there. Round the horn. Out top to Sykes. He kicks it over to Coleman. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Into the corner to Wynn Brown. He drains a three. Wynn Brown with 8 points. Second tray of the game. And now into the front court is Ward. He dribbles it around to the baseline. The Cougars going to milk out the clock as Columbia is going to score a victory here. 82-65, sound the alarm. That's another Cougar victory presented by Alarm Communications. 82-65, Columbia. We're back with a postgame show in a moment. This is Cougar Basketball.
Couldn't have started anywhere but in Sauk City, Wisconsin. Still today, we are a family restaurant. Here, nearby farms grow the food we eat, smiles are contagious, and everyone is someone's neighbor. It's a place where our love of fresh food is as strong as our love for each other. It's a feeling of welcome you'll notice the moment you stop by. Because where we come from has made us who we are. And for that, we couldn't be more proud. Welcome to Delicious.
Hey, you said we need carpet, right?
Well, honey, we need more than carpet. We need carpet for the bedroom, tile for the bathroom, and hard surface flooring for the kitchen and living room.
Wow. So they really do more than carpet.
Yep, that's why they're called Carpet One Floor and Home. They'll help us select the best flooring for our needs.
I think these guys said they do that too.
Guys?
So let's talk fiber. Fiber internet. Fiber internet transfers data via fiber optic cables, which means fiber internet is over 100 times faster than DSL. It's far more reliable, too. There's no interference from electrical equipment, weather, or other complications. Fiber currently delivers speeds up to 1 gigabit per second. So if your household streams TV and movies, downloads music and videos, plays online video games, has multiple devices connected to Wi-Fi, you need Socket Fiber. Ditch the DSL and switch to Socket. Call 1-800-SOCKET3.
Thank you.
Since 1929, we've been here to serve our communities with the best products and the best service. You are the reason we go to work every day, and we thank you for that. After all, we live where you do.
82-65, Cougars post win number 10 on the air as they beat Webster here handily this afternoon. And Coach Thomas Black, your thoughts on your performance, the performance of your team?
Can you hear me? I thought that we, you know, played really well in the first half, super efficient offensively. Wasn't super excited about how we closed out the second half. Thought we could have been a little bit sharper, but sometimes it's hard to maintain focus. And then we also had some open threes that just didn't go in the second half. But you know, credit our guys. They came out early and kind of stretched it out, put it away at halftime, and were able to finish it off.
You got to hand it to Webster. They did not back off. They kept coming at you, didn't they, regardless of what the scoreboard said?
Yeah, they played hard. They made some plays, made some shots in the second half. Some of that was our defense. We fell asleep a little bit at times. But, you know, all in all, a good win. You know, we had a couple guys really step up. I thought Carson Parker had one of his best games, was super efficient offensively. I thought Marlon Allen did a really nice job on both ends as well. So certainly some bright spots in there.
Very dominant on the boards. Of course, you would kind of expect that with a height advantage, but they're quick.
They are quick, and that's one thing we talked about is, you know, limiting their second chance opportunities because they're quick to the ball and they're aggressive on the glass. And I thought we did a decent job of that.
Coach, win number 10 on the year, does that mean anything to you?
You know, hopefully we'll have a few more than that.
Another 10?
Yeah. a couple of good things. Number one, we're stay undefeated at home, which is always good to protect your home court. Got two, you know, this was a nice week, 2-0 this week. A chance to prepare in a lot of ways, not only for a conference game next week, but also for a finals week next week academically. So a lot on our guys' plates right now. On the court and off the court, and they're handling it well.
Yeah, it's one of those times of year that you're kind of happy to see it because you're going to catch a break after the next week, but a very gruesome week here ahead of you.
Yeah, you know, we'll take a couple days off in there to let them focus on academics, but we do. We need to have a good week in the classroom, and we need to have a good week on the court preparing for you know, to go over to Moab and see if we can get one on the road.
How about Missouri Baptist, Coach? 4-0. Looks like they're a real deal.
Yeah, they had kind of a slower start, but part of that was their schedule was really tough early on. And they've come on here as of late, 4-0 in the league, like you said. They're one of the – there's, you know, it's looking like there's going to be three or four teams in the hunt when we get to the second semester from a conference standpoint. Missouri Baptist is definitely one of those teams. So, you know, it'd be nice to go over there and steal one.
Coach, have a good trip over to St. Louis. I guess Merry Christmas is in order. We won't see you till after the first of the year.
That's right. Merry Christmas.
See you. Coach Thomas Brock, his club winners today by a final score of 82-65. We'll be back to sum things up in a moment. This is Cougar Basketball.
Wondering, what is Socket Fiber? Socket Fiber is the fastest, most reliable internet service available in mid-Missouri. So, how do I get Socket Fiber at my house? First, check to see if you currently have Socket Fiber to your home by going to socket.net/fiberhood and checking your address. If Socket does not have fiber currently available to your home, just go to socket.net/fiberhood to request it to your home. Request Socket Fiber today and become the next fiberhood.
Cougars win 82-65, beating Webster with the victory. Columbia College now 10-4 on the year, and they've got one league game left here in the first semester, and then it'll be second semester time. I think there's one other non-conference game. They've got a trip out to Kansas, take on Kansas Wesleyan on the 31st of December before we flip the calendar. So that's their final non-conference matchup left. But they take care of business here today. Webster with a loss falls to 2-9 on the year, snapping a little two-game winning streak that they had. Webster finished the game shooting 43%. They were 25 of 58 from the field, 7 of 15 from the arc for 47%, 8 of 11 from the free throw line, 73%. Only shot one free throw in the first half, but then drove the ball to the bucket in the second half and got to the line. Webster turned the ball over a total of 8 times. Columbia had 8 turnovers. The Cougars out-rebounded Webster by 20. 45-25. Cougars had 16 offensive boards, and Webster with just 6 offensive boards. Columbia shot 49% from the floor. They were 34 of 70, 8 of 25 from the arc for 32%. And from the free throw line, the Cougars were 6 of 7 for 86%. Top score in the game for Webster, couple players with 12 points. 12 points, 8 rebounds for Jamard Sykes II. 12 points and a rebound for Marcus Becton. 10 points in the game for Jason Coleman. And 8 points and a rebound for Wynn Brown. 7 points for Javon Nugent. He had 6 rebounds in the contest. 8 points for Nate Jones. He had 3 rebounds. 3 points for Hawkins, 3 points for Lester, and 2 points for Moore. Cougars were led by our Socket Player of the Game as Colin Parker, 2 games in a row, our Socket Player of the Game, 22 points, 8 rebounds, 2 assists. He did turn it over a couple times as well. 14 points, 3 rebounds for Marlon Allen, 13 points, 5 rebounds for Tony Burks, and 8 points, 2 boards for Trendon Tisdale. Also in double figures today was Brock Davis. Davis put a bid in for the Socket Player of the Game, 10 points and 9 boards he had in an assist. 2 points and 2 rebounds for Tom Hafer, and 4 points and a rebound for Dodo Kara, 3 points and a rebound for Justin Boyer to round out the scoring for the Cougars as Columbia wins it again by a final of 82-65, and they now have 10 wins on the year. It's going to wrap things up here from Southwell this afternoon. Your next chance to see the Cougars in action here will not be until 2023, when the Cougars will entertain the Owls of William Woods. That's the 7th of January. Women tip off at 1, the men at 3 o'clock. For Lucas Green and Tim Fox, I'm Tex Little, saying so long from the Cougar Dome.